I'm Leo Ward of the Kit Guru with two cases from Fractal Design. This is the Fractal Design Define 7, and that is the Fractal Design Define 7 XL. Self-explanatory. The Define 7 replaces the Define R6, which I reviewed 2 years and either 2 or 3 months ago, a terribly long time ago. I loved the R6 when it came out. I built my own PC into that case. I believe I actually reviewed 2 different colours of the R6 and subsequently the S2, which is basically the same case, and then there was the S2 Meshify, by which time it was generally accepted that the design was very long in the tooth. So you might be surprised to see that this Define 7 looks amazingly similar to the R6, but there is a huge amount that's been changed. In this review, I'm going to dwell on the Define 7 rather than the XL. However, I'm going to give you a quick rundown of the differences in the specs of these various models. Let's look at the big boy first. So from the Define XL R2 to the new Define 7 XL, you used to be able to install 8 drives. You can now install a total of either 12 or 14, depending on the configuration inside the chassis. The graphics card can be installed vertically. It's got a Type-C USB. You can install many more fans. You used to be able to install 7 fans. You can now install either 9 140s or 11 120s. And the 3 140mm fans, they used to be model SSR2. They are now the Dynamic X2 GP14. So the old XL and the new XL are quite radically different. Prices for the two cases. The XL is £210. The Define 7 is £170 with tempered glass, cheaper if you go for a solid panel. The Define R6 at the moment you can buy for £145. That's clearly been discounted to clear house. So £145 for the old R6, £170 for the Define 7, which is a surprisingly small premium in my book. As I'm going to show you, you get a huge amount with this case. Even though it looks like a Define R6, it is quite different. How does the new Define 7 compare to the old Define 6? For one thing, many more drives. You still have the option, if you want, of installing a 5 1/4 inch optical drive. The main change is you can now put up to 14 drives inside in standard layout, or if you open it up, you've got a total of 9 drive mounts. Open layout, basically the S2. The idea there is you can put a load of cooling inside. The front I/O has not changed. You've still got the one Type-C, 2 USB 3.0s, 2 USB 2.0s. Fan mounts have changed subtly. It used to be with the R6 you could have 2 140s at the front or 3 120s. You can now have 3 140s at the front or 3 120s. It's the same story at the top. You can now put 3 120s or 140s inside. Previously it was either 2 140s or 3 120s. When it comes to radiators, the differences are more subtle. You can now put a 360 or 420 in the roof, whether the chassis is in open or standard configuration. Previously with the R6, it made a big difference which configuration you were using. So if you had all the drive bays installed, that limited the cooling. Now you can have the best of both worlds. At the front, you can have a 280 or a 360 rad. That hasn't changed. The Define 7 is slightly larger than the R6. However, Fractal promises us that there is significantly more space inside for cable management, up from 23mm, which is a bit tight, to 30mm, which should be capacious. However, till we get inside, we ain't gonna know for sure. So the way it's looking to me is the XL. If you've got that old XL model, this new XL is a completely different beast. Superficially, the Define 7 hasn't changed much from the R6. It looks completely familiar as I stand here. But when I pull it apart, as you will see, it is completely different. Color options for the Define 7, black, white, gunmetal gray. You don't have the option of the weird black, white hybrid that Fractal often gives us. The XL is black only. If you choose to go for the Define 7 without tempered glass with a solid panel, you save £10. Inside the box, in addition to the case, you get the Define 7 user guide. And I have to confess, having seen the natty blue cover, I quite like the idea of a case in blue. Just a thought. You also get this enormous box of accessories. What is in the box? The The reason it's so large is that it includes an alternate top panel. Under the foam, we've got a regular accessory pack, one drive sled, two drive sleds, three and four. The inclusion of these four accessory drive mounts, plus some already installed inside the case, goes to the heart of Fractal's approach. So while the Define 7 supports 11 3.5, 2.5 inch drives, six brackets are included. They spell that out in the specification. Similarly, with the 2.5 inch drives, it supports four dedicated SSD mounts, of which two are supplied. Seems reasonable. I mean, that's a monumental number of drives, so the total potential is not the same as the number of drives you can install when you buy the case. You have to buy some accessories. And let's look at how this case comes apart. So the side panel, no tools. Simply let it rock out, lift it away. Same with the back panel. And clearly, if you had a solid panel on the front side, it would be one of those. The top panel, generally, thumb screws and away, nothing of the sort. There are no fasteners. You lift it at the back and you wiggle it. It latches at the front and comes off. If you want to install the alternate top panel, simple as that. Once you're inside the top, pull the filter back, lift it away. At the front, bottom filter slides out, that's very R6. And there we have the door covering the front filter. Pulls out relatively easily. Above that front filter, there's a small filter that sits where an optical drive would go. You remove the fan, put the bay in place, lose that filter, wallop, you now have an optical drive at the front. The front panel allows you to reverse the door if you want, so you take out these two little blanking plates, undo the two screws there, flip the hinges over to this side. So should you wish to reverse the door because of access under your desk, easy peasy. And there we are inside the chassis. So this is still looking quite R6, except that getting inside was so blooming simple. However, this is definitely something new. Two screws and the top rack pulls away to open the inside of the chassis like you've never seen before. To install cooling or to mod panels and some such, dead easy. On the back side, we've got attention to detail when it comes to cable management, hook and loop straps and channels for the cables to run in. And there, a simple cover to hide the mess. There we have the pair of SSD mounts that I mentioned before, and there are the two drive bays. So here we have some storage around this side, nice and clean. Putting the bare bones of the PC together is dead straightforward with all this access. Absolutely fabulous. The Seasonic Focus power supply slips in place from the rear without any difficulty. The cables run up the back through those channels. That's all dead straightforward. And the ATX X570 motherboard from Gigabyte, no problems whatsoever. And the positioning of the grommets for the EPS connector and for the main power could hardly be any better. So far, so good. Now it's time for the cooler. My chosen cooler is a Fractal Designs Celsius S36, so a 360mm Ace Tech that is assembled on this clever top bracket, and it's simply drops into place. That's the PC built, just got to put a few panels on. The cable management, dead straightforward. Love the way that panel snaps on. Main compartment is looking good. As I've got the liquid cooler in the top, I'm going to use the alternate top panel. And on with the glass. Power on. Damn, that was easy. You may be able to hear a whooshing of air, but no more than that, as this PC is currently flogging itself to death under Ada 64. The spec is very similar to the build I did for that Zalman cooler testing a week or two back, Ryzen 9 3900X. It's running at 4.1 GHz. I also tested at 4.25 GHz overclock. Motherboard, Gigabyte X570 Aorus Elite. Memory is G.Skill TridentZ Neo. Power supply, Seasonic Focus PX850 Platinum. It's all good stuff. Temperatures are good with the Celsius S36 in the roof of the case. The three 140mm fan supply to stock, so two at the front, one at the rear, are rated at 1000 RPM. Hence, they are nice and quiet on auto mode. In fact, they're quiet on full mode. And the same is true of the PWM fans on the Celsius S36. I'm quite sure this case has the potential to be noisy if you put faster, louder fans in place, as it is, after all, open at the top and at the rear. However, it is fully filtered, so there is some noise baffling. It's an interesting case. I like it a lot. The way it comes apart and goes back together is absolutely superb. It's big inside, but not too huge on the outside, so kind of TARDIS-y. And I think it is significant that I have not used these four drive bay accessories, and I have not used the various accessories that Fractal sent me in case I wanted to install a load of extra storage. Also, in the intro, I probably wasn't crystal clear about the optical drive bay mount. You don't have to add an extra mount. There's a little bracket up the top, and you simply hang the optical drive off that. So if you want an optical drive in your PC build, I personally haven't used an optical drive in a long time, a surprise number of KitGuru readers do, however, then it couldn't be simpler to install. What do I think of the Define 7? I like it a lot. I wish to goodness that this is what the Define R6 had been 2 years ago. Looking at it, I see no reason why it couldn't have been built back then. What's clearly happened is the designer has taken a fresh look at the case, and they've just gone back to basics and gone, well, why have we got it this way? And why does the top have a rack that slots into place and then screws in? Why not just have a top that comes away in its entirety, and so on and so forth? And the result is this. It's a stealth case. It just is. It works brilliantly well. It gives you loads of options, and I've used almost none of them in this build. However, I have some liquid cooling hardware to work with in the near future, and I think this case is going to get a good run with a liquid cooled build, probably in a month, maybe two. This case has a lot going for it. One thing it doesn't have, however, obviously, is RGB. The only RGB is on the TridentZ Neo memory, and also the lighting on the edge of the RTX 2080. So understated, as I say, whether you want RGB or not, you know that. That is the single biggest dividing line between this case and, say, the Fantex Evolve X. They do surprisingly similar jobs in quite different ways. Fantex includes RGB, Fractal does not. I have to say the Fractal looks quite expensive, but it feels like quality. And when I say expensive, I'm talking about if they were to cut the price by £10 or £20, which as a percentage is fairly trivial, and in the great scheme of things is not worth dwelling on. The Fractal Design Define 7 has a long list of good points. Almost everything about it is good. On the negative side, the price may be a tad high. The three fans included are not PWM models, and the fan hub is split half PWM, half non-PWM. I don't understand that. I want PWM fans and a full PWM hub, and then I'd be as close to being entirely happy as you'll ever see me get. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, hit the bell button, subscribe. I'm Leo Wood for KitGuru. This is the Fractal Design Define 7.